could do that. So the let's see, the things that I would edit would be hair, face. I have a mouth that opens and closes. Okay. I'm getting a read on what you're putting down, yeah. Okay, so he gets ragdolled. Got it. So head. Maybe like the eyes don't really change at all. So that part is static. The mouth is going to be two different mouths. So. Okay, cool. So the ritual's working, is what you're saying. Like, off screen from what's going on. You know? And then we'll do like an H front all in one layer. I think I need to move everything down a little bit. Oh, I need to play some music again. I turned it off. Okay. Harvey's appearance changes, gains horns, and don't tell them the face. Okay, so he basically gain he like sucks the demon power out of them. Or is it a little bit more complicated than that? Like what is the causation that causes him to sort of absorb those demon powers? Is I guess what my question would be. Oh, he was cursed in the last second. Okay, I'm getting what you're saying now. Yeah, okay. Memories bring back you. Yeah, smoky Mozzie time. Let's do the highest part of the outfit. Everybody hurts someday. Toast to the ones that we lost on the way. Yeah, no problem. I think that was a really good story. I think, it's too often that people don't do much with their OCs and have these really cool stories, and I encourage you to like write it down, do like a mini comic, even if you don't feel like you have like the artistic vision for something like that. Like, it's still fun to like get the story out and you like nail down the concrete parts of it and be able to share it with others that way too. You know what I mean? Even if you just make it like a short story where you write everything down, I think it's definitely worth it. Yeah, that'd be really cool. I think that's a great idea. What Mogi doing now? Yeah, Mogi's working on some prizes from my Twitter drawing. I'm formatting it for animation in Live 2D instead of in Flash. I gotta kind of section it off. So it'll all fit in the frame. Memories bring back you. Yeah, that sounds like a really good OC. H front three. And the last element I need is probably gonna be. Probably need to fix more on the front bangs. Do a little bow and a ponytail. This goes behind the head. Toast to the ones that we lost on the way. Okay, and then I'm gonna need. Her ponytail. How's Moogie today? Moogie's just hanging out. Moogie was gonna stream Genshin tonight, but I don't know if I feel like it, honestly. No. Okay, I just need the ponytail now. Do they have like a cowlick on the ponytail? Well, they have glasses! Cheers to the wish you were here, but you're not. Yeah, I thought about it, but like I said, like I was doing the Genshin streamer or whatever, and I signed up for it and did a little bit of time, but like, it's a busy month, and I gotta finish this stuff too, you know? Can't leave it undone forever. And I don't want to be streaming all night either. Let's see, and then ponytail. You could use some bosses. Yeah, but then what am I gonna do? side ponytail, so as long as it's like far enough to this side, as the head being at its lowest position. Yeah, then I should be good. That should be the highest position. Ponytail. Okay. So this is gonna be. Now I'm gonna put a musical note here. Get all this stuff just. How do I show and like do everything at once? Oh, there we go. I was like, I need to make everything invisible. How do I do that? Okay. Cheers to the wish you were here, but you're not. Yeah, I might not tonight. Nah. So I'm putting in the middle because I kind of want to have it go from side to side like this. So let's see. Face, note. Let me put this in the digital folder. Okay. And now I have another base to make for an emote. So let's go ahead and get that started. So this OC, let me. I saved the reference, but I don't know where it went. It's gotta be in this folder. Where did it go? Where did it go now? It go? Sort by most recent. I guess I didn't save it. Oh, conies will do that to you though. This thing is shaped like a bean. Worth eats a coney. Worth. Oh, I didn't need it to be a perfect circle. I needed it to be an elongated circle. So I kind of got it. No, go back. I just got it perfect and then fucking jinxed it by laughing. That's okay. Okay. Oh, okay. What's the expression chart? Yeah, that's fair. I think instead of this, I'll just use it as a, size reference, because yeah. Me and Taka's favorite colors? I like orange. Taka likes like blues, kinda like navy blues. Yeah. It's already the holidays. Isn't that crazy? I've run into a problem. Okay. I made the canvas like the exact size that I need, and then like, but now I can't fit the room for the animated thing. Test to the ones that we lost on the way. I think this one is like the way easier one to animate, actually. Okay, yeah, there's no background. What? Mogi like pickles. Why you ask why Mogi like pickles? Wait, 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 wait. Oh, okay. Love you too. Gross, love. Yeah, super gross. Disgusting. Sorry you had to hear some gross love. Huh? Oh, he's on the phone. Oh, he's got a little ponytail. Get that love shit behind locked doors. I'm trying, man. Toast to the ones that we lost on the way. What did you just realize? Oh no, did it update? What the fuck is it calculating this off of? Oh, maybe it got mad when I rotated things. Wild. The fuck? Why does it think that there is a. Why does it think that there's something on this layer? Uh-oh. Yeah, I didn't know when the next banner started. I wasn't really paying attention to all that. Oh. Well, did you actually miss it? I know there was supposed to be a banner soon, but. Oh, you could probably just look it up on the internet way faster. This is self-torture. Okay. Whatever method you choose, it's up to you, I mean. One day, 23 hours. Yeah, you got it. Why is the tolerance so fucking high? Okay. Yeah, see, there's nothing to worry about. Okay, and let me add his little ponytail before I forget. Yeah. Yeah. Genshin is so much. Get it. 22 pity, get it. Everything we've been through. Why are there two extra layers up here? There's literally nothing that they're doing. Oof. Burple? Benny? What are you gonna do with that? Hey, that's a free wish. That's a single pull right there. Oh no. Are you only opening the wallet because Tall is not there to stop you? You know what? It is the last week, so I mean, if you want it, pay the money for it. Get your Genshin rolls. You've earned it. You know your monies. Oh, yeah, that's right. You guys have separate money. Yeah, treat to you from you. Let's go. Purple Noel. Razor Constellation, let's go. Razor Constellation crew be like. Oh man, okay. Let me sit up, stretch. And hydrate. Thank you. So I'm missing a little earring, and I think the tips of their bangs live also have a little bit of that color in them. Memories bring back you. Who am I drawing? Oh, I'm drawing some prizes from my Twitter giveaway. So this one is Endless, INDLUS. Yeah, I did do that. C6 Noel. Ayy. That's the good shit, though. Okay, so now that up there. Oh. There we go. It didn't actually fix anything. All right, that's one. Okay. Save that as a PSD. 60. P1 preview. P2 preview. Close that. Okay, and now, wait, I need that. I need the color reference. Okay. Nub. Just a little nub. Just a nubbin. Fettuccine. Eyes don't need a color layer. Hair front. Alright, the bow is the same color as the tie. The gold is the same color as the hair, that's what I thought. Just three. No, it's two on both sides. Okay. An absolute nubbin. Okay. Memories bring back, memories bring back you. It's Stretch. Stretch. Fine. Ooh, that was my neck. Whew. Here's to the wish you were here, but you're not. Of everything we've been through. Huh. Yeah. Oof. That is the worst. Biggest silly skeleton move imaginable. Oh, man. That's super fair though. That's the way their bangs are parted. Okay. Okay, Maki, go do cleaning things. Miso from peas? Oh. bring back memories, bring back you. Oh, I got a file error. Love that. I should probably do. Yeah. Okay. All the elements are there, they're not in the right place, but they all exist. So I'm going to save a preview. And then I'm going to combine these layers so that I have all the elements basically ready to be worked on. Okay, all those are ready. Right and left. Oh, I didn't do a highlight like I wanted to on this one, so I'm gonna add that in this version. Let's do an overlay of the same color. I wanted to do a highlight. Yeah, that works. Mirror front. Okay, these are glasses. this is the bow. And lastly is the music note. Okay. So now each individual piece is a separate layer. I save that as a new file, and then I save it as a PSD. So those are both ready for animation now. Yay! I made progress. Now, I haven't started on cheeses, but it's, I sketched it. I think that counts as a starting. Let's see. Okay, so let's see if I can get this. Let's do the display capture. That way you can kind of see my screen. Okay, we're gonna open. Actually, no, we're gonna do new model. We're just gonna do it in here. So. Edit, settings, I wanted to change the settings. Oh, okay. Let's do an even canvas. There we go. So I don't need any of these fucking folders. Get rid of those. Okay. We're gonna go drag and drop. Let's grab, boy, where did my PSD go? Oh, this is in alphabetical order. Okay, we're just gonna drag and drop this PSD in. Create new model with PSD file. Here he is. It's just one solid piece, because these are just going to move in and out of frame, essentially. So, we only need a few real parameters. So let's go ahead and make some mesh. Heavy deformation. I'm gonna be stinky and do heavy deformation, but it'll be fine. View. Heavy deformation. And there's this thing. Auto mesh. Standard. Got it. Okay. So, the way that I would do this is probably going to be just random parameters. Given it an assignment. I need transformers though, don't I? Okay, let's make a warp. Okay. And I'm gonna say, can I not rename it easily? Edit. Oh, okay. Move in. One. Edit parameter, the default is 0. Let's put the default at negative 30. So the default is going to be him Not in frame. This is gonna be our middle frame. Okay. Let's do another parameter. And I'm gonna call this move in two. Actually, I only need me big dummy. Okay, so let's actually restart. I only need two. Why am I doing three? One, two, one, two, one. Okay. Where did I make this deformer? Get rid of that. Okay. He doesn't have to go as far, so I'm gonna try and pull him down so he's even though. Because then it's gonna move at a different speed. Okay, they're both off frame. This motherfucker is in here. No, I messed up. Okay, hold on. Okay, hold on. I have a thought. Pull this out. Get rid of that. He's here, right? Put this here. Now put it in, then drag it away. Got it. Okay. Now we want this to have its own little rotation. But we want, hello. We want the one where you can draw it. Like that. There we go. Get rid of that. It's this one. That's where it goes. I don't want to make another one. Okay. Now we have one more parameter that we need to make, and that's going to be wiggle time. Bro, what? All right. Wiggle time. I think actually needs to go on the model itself because of the way that I'm doing this. Memories bring back, memories bring back you. I need to edit this mesh. Don't put that random mesh there. Hey, I'm doing good. How are you doing? I wish it would zoom out correctly, please. Oh. What? Go down. That's good. I'm glad you're doing great. I didn't mean to do that. Go back. There we go. How do I lock this for a second? There we go. OC's job is being a menace. Why does he keep selecting something that I've told it specifically that I don't want to see? Get out of there. What the fuck? What's the button to select a bunch of these fuckers? There it is. Yeah, I'm doing a little bit. It's waving. Okay. So if this side goes out. We want this side to also go out at the same time. And then come back in. Ah! Look at him flap with his little arms. I love this. Okay, hold on. I also want to make his ears wiggle. So what is if my OC had a job? I don't know.
Bro's going wild. Okay. So we're gonna put him away. Bring in this one. All right. We're gonna go to wiggle time. On one side, I'm gonna grab this ear. Rotate it a little. Just gonna straighten it out a little. What we want to do is just kind of keep the mesh from going too wonky over here. So on this side, keep the eye from going in too much. Man, his eye's bugging out. There we go. Let's edit this mesh. We do not want the arms and the face connected. Attach all these. We're gonna move this in. So it's not pulling on those bones when it, of everything we've been through. Okay. Why is there a missing piece of mesh right here? That's weird. Okay. I don't know why there's like a random piece of mesh missing. That's really weird. Okay, that fixed it. Alright, wiggle time. So we're doing, let me see what I did on this one. Arms down is on this side. Okay. Oh God. Woo. Okay, and this one is arms in. Please grab this vertice. Is there a part I'm missing? No, I'm not. It just doesn't know what to do when these two lines intersect, so I'm just gonna leave it so that you cannot focus too much on the intersection. So, like, get where the lines intersect and then do that. And let's just straighten up the mesh a little bit. Party! Okay. So let's save. Perfect. It's already in the right folder. We love to see it. Okay. Now let's do new animation. Let's do video. So let's bring the Indus straight on in. There we go. I was like, I know I gotta drag it somewhere. And we need to edit the scene. Canvas settings. The inspector palette. The inspector palette doesn't want me to change anything. That's not right. What do you mean, do the inspector palette? My man. New template. That's not helping. Why has this happened to me? I made my mistakes. Create new group. No, I don't need that. To the inspector. Thanks. Tool details, log deformer. I do not know how on earth to change the size, because there's this. This is the only thing that's over here. These are our only parameters. Honestly, we could have deleted the rest of the parameters before importing, but you know. Man, what the fuck? Come on, Inspector. Create new scene. No, that's not gonna do it. Template, no. is obnoxious. Settings. In the settings. That's not what I want. Model statistics. Why is it doing this to me? I am going to scream at the top of my lungs. That's to check the inspector. Do I need to do it on? Oh, here we go. No, I don't want an aspect ratio. I want it 500 by 500. Thank you. So now we want to put the model right there. These are keyframes. We love them, but we don't. Insert keyframe. So this is our starting point. I'd say about 24, 48. Oh, perfect. Insert keyframe. So I think in the sample they gave me, kind of like a 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2. Yeah. So, assuming they're moving in and out at the same pace, that means they'll move in about in the increments of 12. So 36. So over here, what we want is to be in here. Have this there. Okay, and then by this frame, he's gone. Okay, by the middle frame here, he's in. By the middle frame here, he's gone. And then I could probably make it one frame shorter because this is the frame where it technically resets. So it would be like this. That's really fast. I think I'm gonna take all these frames and shift them down one. Because then there's no delay between them moving up. Maki's tired of packing. Damn. So that is on the loop. And then I need to make this. Where's the loop button? That's the duration. I gotta fix it a little more, but you know. So what needs to happen is the part where he's coming in needs to be a little faster, and the part where he is at the checkpoint, he needs to be there for a few seconds before he goes back down. So we're gonna do that here too, where we insert a keyframe. Cool. So what I'm gonna do is, instead of getting the midpoint by here, we're gonna get to 75%. And then he's gonna stick around for a few more frames before disappearing. Okay, now let's duplicate that on the other side. So, by the halfway point here, that's the halfway point. Oop. By the halfway point here, we're going to have him 75% in. And before he retreats, we're going to give him a few extra frames where he is staying completely up. Now let's look at it. So now it's a little bit more like this. They kind of stick around for a second, and they hop in really fast. They're both on the same cadence and beat. Now let's apply our effects. Okay. So when he gets up here, I'm going to say about here. Trying to get more of a little bit of a more even wiggle on the thing. So it's coming in, hit the stop gap, kind of flings. I think I need to calm it down a little bit. So flings, bounce, and then goes out. So. Yeah, there we go. Okay. And now when he comes up, I'd say about here is when we want to activate our wiggle. So, and then it's returning to normal as he goes away. So let's see what that looks like. You wiggle! Okay. Now let's do that on the other one. So when it hits normal at half frame, when it hits about 9 is when we're gonna start it on the left, right on 12, and then back on 15. So when it hits the stop, so it'd be about here. And then wiggle the other way. Wiggle the last way, and then as he's leaving, it goes back to normal. Alright? There we go! It's an animated emote. Alright. So let's go back to the beginning. We'll save this animation file. And then we want to try exporting it to a GIF without the program crashing. Export as a GIF animation, 500 by 500, loop, high quality, background transparent. Let's try that and see if it'll work. This is going to be... Alright. It's a little goofy, but... Yep, there it is. Completely transparent for Twitch channels. There he goes. Alright, we got one more to make. So let's go ahead and close this. I love how convenient Live2D is. For even, like, the most simplest application. I'm getting distracted, sorry. Okay, now let's get... Okay, we're gonna do a little bit more with this one, but yeah, Mogi getting distracted? Yeah, for real. So first thing we want to do is I actually want to put the elements where they belong in the frame, because they are not where they belong in the frame right now. So the bow goes up here. This music note, I'm just gonna get out of the way for a second. What I wanted to do is I wanted to have all these elements, created, but I didn't want to put them where they needed to go, because then, not everything would fit in the frame properly. So, the body actually goes down here. Okay. And we're gonna make this a little bit smaller. Okay. I don't think we actually need any mesh, so we can actually do these on a just like one single fucking thing, I think, for the most part. So, let's start with the music note. So this is its basic movement. That's done. Let me look at the 3-frame example Cordy gave me. It's a little bit of a headbang. I think the only thing I'll have to actually mesh is this. Her hair. So let's just do a standard mesh. And then I might do the bow, because I think that might be fun. Everything else should be like a minimum movement. So this one is going to be, whoop. Where's the other mouth? We're gonna start with the farthest to the left. Eyes. Gauss's. Okay, and I think in neutral position that this mouth is also going to be invisible. I think the only time it's going to be visible is on the upside. So and on this upside, this mouth will not exist. But here, it will. Okay, I'll stretch. Ooh. Thanks, Maki. I'm being good to myself, I promise. Okay. So on this one, she's doing a little bit of a headbang, so on this side is when her clothes are higher up. She's crunchy. See? She's crunchy. She's crunchy. I'm corny. It's so cute, but it's so funny to just like puppeteer somebody else's VTuber. Is this considered disrespectful? I'm having a good time. It is so cute, though. Oh yeah, I remember. I want to do a deformer here. That's not right. Not the right one. Okay. To the side. Did I not? I did produce mesh. Okay. Trying to figure out why it's. Oh, I see it now. I was like, where's the fucking button? Boom. Crunchy, 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 crunchy. Oh, what the hell? That's not what I wanted to do. Got a little bean face. Well, I'll do it in accordance to wherever the face ends up. So let's do. Did I get everything, though? That's the thing that I'm worried about. Every element is moving. Okay. Now we need an upper limit. Head banging. Alright. Okay. Ah, that's not what I meant to do. Everything will stay the same. There's a clip right here, like clipping. There we go, that solves it. Damn, okay. Go ahead and save this where it's at, just in case I lose progress or this program crashes, because it loves to do that. Okay. I think I forgot the glasses. I was like, I know there's something that's not, that I did not fix. I kind of want them going fucking wild all over the place. I feel like that's kind of funnier if they're just kind of like getting thrown around the face, but I don't think you can really tell if I'm doing that in the first place. So I think I should just do it to help exaggerate the eyes, and that should be enough. Just have them sort of sliding around the face a little bit, but not too much. You know what I mean? That move up a little faster too. There we go. Now I feel like the bangs are a little funky. try and straighten him out, but there's also just like a weird shape going on. I kind of want to exaggerate the motion just a little bit more. You know what I mean? Just like, I think I also would want to just like redo this parameter. So I feel like it was getting too stretched out by the deformer and not like actually looking good. So I think making it just a little bit crunchier. I feel like this one also doesn't have enough drama. You know, so I'm gonna pull it back. So she's kind of squashing. I wanted to move it in, but the head is like fucking it up. Okay. A mesh. Oh. Ta-da. Okay, I think the other thing is that the head is moving up, but this is just rotating. So I think I need to actually move it up. And I think that helps too. And that's 3 frames. So if I need another frame, what I would do is I'd go in here and I'd insert 2 more, but I don't technically need to do that. So let's go ahead and save it again real quick. Create a new animation movie. We don't want to constrain the proportions here. We want them 500 by 500. And we're going to import QWERTY. Once again, I should have deleted all these extra parameters that I'm not using, but, you know. We're going to make this... How fast do we want it to go? 1, 2, 1, 2, 2, 1, 2. Okay, so what we want to do, let's go ahead and do our beginning keyframes. Probably at least want to do 12. But I'm going to shoot for 24 frames. So this first one starts in the middle, goes up on 6, back down, and at 18, oh, that's the wrong frame, and at 18 would come back down the other way. And then reset. So it's like this. I might make it a little bit choppier. Okay, but I think that's not so bad. Okay. And then we want the default for QWERTY to be here. We want her to pull back. Medium. Lurch forward, return. And if we want to make it a little choppier, we can. So let's try a little choppier. And I think it's also, I think the sample they gave me is also faster. 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1. So I think we should do this in half time of what I have here. So I'm going to move these to 3. Move these to 6. That's 7. This one is 9. And put the last frame on. On 12. So let's try that. Speed. That's closer. Now to make it choppy. Ta-da. Let's try that. It's semi-choppy. That looks a little odd. Why is it doing that? So, middle, top, middle, middle. Oh, because it's already decided where its middle frames are, so... So it's bouncing where it doesn't need to. don't know. I feel like it's missing something. I want to kind of double the music note. Its frames, because I feel like it. Needs to be doubled. Because I feel like it's kind of too fast. Oh, am I too quiet? Huh? Am I too quiet, Tat? Am I too quiet? Oh, you want me to turn it up? Hee hee hee. Thanks, babe. Eternal brain rot.
Whoa, I'm stretching, monkey. I promise I'm stretching.
I think it's spending too many frames on the final one. So if I chop that down one. I think it's still spending too many frames in the middle. So let's try that. Yeah, that's a little bit choppier. I'm zipping. I think that music note's going too fucking fast. I kind of want to make, like, one that's a little bit cursed, gonna be honest. So what I would do now... No, you're fine! Oh my god. So let's open this back up to 24. I'm gonna take these frames. And we're gonna copy. And then from here to 24... You're gonna paste. Oh, thank God. Oh. Hey, give me the... Of everything we've been through. And now the music note, I'm gonna elongate its frames. So we're gonna cut. Just get rid of those. So normal at 6, 12, 18, and 24. So... Something more like this. There's a delay on that last frame, so I'm gonna cut it one. And that should loop better. There we go. She's yelling. So let's save. Oh. Save as. Okay. And now Oh, oof. export. Twelve. Oh, did I export the other one as 16? I'll have to check and make sure. As long as it shows up and does fine, though, I don't think it's that big a deal. As long Oh. Uh-oh. We fucked her up a little bit. That should be right. Let's try again. Something messed up there. Loop. Okay, let's try this. QWERTY dance. Overwrite. Why is it going out? That's not supposed to happen. I think I needed to have this bar farther up. Because one of them is for the model in the scene and the other one's for the actual animation, and I think I got them backwards. Let's save QWERTY dance one more time. Yeah, Control Z, Control Z. It's still doing it. That's really weird. That's so weird. Oh. Is it that duration bar that's having the issue with me? One of these bars is having such an issue. I'm gonna export it as a completely different one. And see if I just can't do it on that same one because it's cursed. Yeah, that one's fine. It's still spinning like a frame too long on the middle. One, two. Three. One, two, three. One, two, three. Nope. One, two, three. I think it's because one of them spins it on two that it makes it feel uneven. But I don't know if anybody would actually notice that aside from me. Like, okay, now I want to make a really cursed version. Hold on. This is just for me. So I'm gonna save as cursed. So this is a new animation file. Now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take all the middle files out. So it's just I should actually, what I should do is I should just take out the keyframes. So, cut. So it'll be down, up, I'll give it 3 keyframes. So, like... Please don't crash. Why did it go that way? Okay. And on this keyframe, it's going to be all the way up. And then it's going to be all the way down. And then it's going to be all the way up. And it's going to keep doing this. This is the whole plan. I'm just having fun with it. I keep asking this program not to crash on me, and then I keep doing shit like this. True tomfoolery. The song is too fast. So this is and this one's the regular one. Ta-da!